What is up, everybody, and welcome to a brand new Let's Play. As you can tell by the title, we are doing an adventure map today, Pixelmon Heart of Ice. And if you guys do remember, a few weeks back, I did play Pixelmon Soul of Fire. This is the, you know, second version of that map by the same developers, the, next of kin, I guess you could say. I don't know how to word it, but yes, I figured I would show me picking my starter. I know I normally don't do this, but hey, it's time to mix it up, and I think I'm going to go with Mudkip, as always. And here we go. So it does look like there's a little Pichu right there. Hello, a little Pichu statue. There is a chest right here. Rules, welcome back. Rules and introduction. So let's click the start button and begin our journey. Oh, there you go. You're now ready for your new journey. Good luck. So let's read these actual books first. So welcome back. Hey there, welcome back to our Pixelmon map series. Now we hope you enjoy the second part of the story and complete all the quests in the map. Special thanks to Desmond X the Builder. And rules, play on peaceful, do not break any blocks or frame, follow every rule or sign you see. This is a single player map, play in adventure mode, enjoy. So let's set it to peaceful if it isn't already. How do I do that again? Options. Actually, I have no idea how to set it. Oh, it's right there. Okay. That was pretty awkward. All right. I have to go to this. So wait, what is this one entitled? Introduction. Story. It's been 3 years since the legendary bird Moltres was captured by Team Rocket and saved by an unknown hero that defeat them all. That is the events of the previous map, if you do not remember. Now Team Rocket is planning to capture the second legendary bird, and the police department and his boss John are trying to stop them. John is your father, and today it's your birthday, so we gave you your first Pokemon to start your journey. Good luck. All right, let's do this, baby. So it looks like this may be our home. I am obviously using shaders, so it's going to be very hard to see at night. We do have Player One. Oh, it looks like this is a little starting kit. So I'll throw the three books in here because, frankly, I don't think we'll be using them much in the first, beginning sections of this. So it does appear we do have some emeralds, which, if based off the last map, are probably going to be the currency. 5 Pokeballs to start out. We do have a wonderful Pokédex and a few books. We have John's Letter, Before You Leave, and Leader di Trieno. So, Letter of True? This book was a mistake in the last map. There's a Pokeball behind the house, and go get it. Oh yeah, there was a mistake in the last. I do remember that. So let's read John's letters first. John, I had to do some important stuff in the police department. Please take care of your new partner and friend. Now it's the start of your journey, so go and train and challenge the gyms. The gyms are... Gyms. 1, Bug. 2, Ghost. 3, Steel. 4, Ice. And 5, Fire. Then once you beat them, you will be able to challenge the Elite Four. Alright, so that sounds good. Don't forget to sleep. It's too late for going out. Alright, so let's go to sleep. Right now, it will become daytime, and we'll begin our journey. There's another chest on the other side, so I should probably go check that out as well. And, oh, that must be for Player 2, if there was a Player 2. Yeah, and there's a second bed and everything. So these chests, if it's anything like last time, will be empty. Yes, they all seem to be empty. I'll check the Furnace Eye, too, just in case. Alright, so let's open these doors and embark on our journey. So let's see, we do have a few Hitmonchan right here, and this obviously does look very, very different. And as we did discover, there is a Pokeball back here behind the house and right there, if you could see it. And we got a Pokeball, a fastball, so that's pretty good. We're gonna want to use that probably on some Pokemon or another. We could close our doors just to be safe rather than sorry. And so obviously starting with a Mudkip, as it is Heart of Ice. So I wanted to go with a water Pokemon, and we're gonna have to catch a ice Pokemon very early on in the series, but that's okay. So let's close these doors and let's go battle. You're way too high level for me. I think I saw a the little fighting dude. What's his name? I forgot his name now. Uh-oh. So, Fire Gym Info. Oh, is that the first gym? John, no, what is it? Before You Leave. Is it this? Was this the one that said? Oh, yeah. So, Fire's the last gym, so we cannot challenge him yet. But as you can see, he does have a Charizard standing next to him. That does look like quite the scary gym right there. Ooh, we do have the shop right here, so Let's talk to them. A feather, so all the Pixelmon drops you can trade for some emeralds, and then with our 15 emeralds we can buy all of various things, and there's an ender chest right there for some storage. So yeah, I just kind of want to get a little feel for the town right now. What is that guy's name? Not Golem. The Golem's first evolution. I saw one of him. I thought that would be a good Pokemon to battle, but he ran away. Oh no, he's right here. Geodude. Oh crap, yeah. Geodude is a way higher level than me. So, if we do remember, I don't think, was it the first episode? It was one of the first episodes in the last series where we did find a shiny. So, we're going to keep our eye open in this series as well. Oh, we didn't go in that house. The big house right there. That does look like it may be the lab of sorts. So, let's go try and check this out. We will see what is inside. And what do we got here? Insert key here. Oh, I don't have a key yet, so cannot go in the lab, unfortunately. Ooh, what is that? Oh, nothing. So let's continue on this way, and we'll see what our journey prevails. Again, I've seen some pictures of this map. I also do want to note, if you want to play the map, links in the description down below to the Planet Minecraft page. It'll be on all the videos, so if you want to wait till later, or, you know, wait for a few days, there may be a few bug fixes. As again, the map only came out today. Oh, Pokeball. I got a Sunstone. Oh. As I call it, that'll actually be kind of useful. What is the first gym again? I keep forgetting. It's a bug gym. So we could go try and catch like a Oddish or something and evolve it. That would not be too bad. So we do have tickets right here. What is this? Oh, I see. So you could get a Pokemon League ticket. Oh, that's cool. So that looks like it's the end. That is how you get to the city. And this is the training fields. And this is the Pokemon League. So I see. This is how you buy them. So you have to get the ticket, and then you can get the little thing there. So that's pretty cool. What is in here? I don't know. It's like a little bus of sorts. And oh, getting battled already. So now comes the wonderful question: will I be able to run away? Nope. Do I use Poke Heal or do I not? I don't know. I don't think cheats are enabled right now. But I don't know. I think for the first few levels, I'm going to use Poke Heal, and then towards the later end of the series, I won't. Only because in the beginning here, we would have to run back all the time, and I'd rather not do that. So let's travel this way a bit. I know there are some pretty cool scenery, but we're obviously going to have to make our way to each individual town first. And holy crap, look at all. Look at all the Pokemon spawning. It is quite the beautiful world, isn't it? A boss! We found a boss Machop right off the bat. So, I'm gonna guess he's gonna be, like, a super high level. Look how... Oh my god, dude, this is perfect for the, what is it? What is it called? Heart of Ice. Yes, I keep forgetting the name. But a blue boss Machop right on the first episode of Heart of Ice. He fits in so perfectly. There's no way I'm gonna be able to kill him, though. So, that's kind of unfortunate. So, I'm gonna try and find a lower level Pokemon. Maybe we'll be able to level up. You know what? Let's just see what level he is. If we don't, like, if we battle him and lose... Oh, he's only level 15. We could tackle. Not too confident, yeah. Did he just despawn? Oh, no, we didn't. All right, so let's Poke Heal again real quick. And we'll just keep an eye on that Machop. We'll try not to lose him. And if we could go take on someone a bit closer to our level, we may be in good shape to actually kill him and get whatever he drops. So it does look like the second... Ooh, look at that. If anything, from the last series, that big tower is probably a gym of sorts. So let's go battle some of these Magikarp. And oh, what happened? I missed. Let's try again. There you go. So a level 18 Magikarp. Ooh, I should catch one of these and try and get a Gyarados. But I think as long as he doesn't use... Oh, no, he did use an offensive move on me. But as long as he doesn't use too many offensive moves on me... Uh-oh. He is using offensive moves on me. He's going to just keep using Splash, bro. Use Tackle. All right, let's go find a lower level Magikarp. And again, I don't want to lose that Machop. Because again, we just kill like two or three Magikarps. And I think we could take on the Machop. So I want to keep him nearby. And we'll try and just train up really quickly. And let's see. What level are you? Level 14? That's better. But it's not great. So let's battle this one. Level 14 as well. So I guess that's good enough. And we'll use Tackle on him. As long as he doesn't tackle me to death, I should be okay. And so far, so good. I don't know. I don't think there's sound right now. I think that's on my end, though. So I'll fix that in the next episode. Do not worry. Just listen to the wonderful, wonderful music. So let's continue to tackle. And yeah, hopefully we'll gain a good few experience. Look at him. They're splashing out right now. Frolicking in the air, the Magikarp does do. I could totally catch one of these guys. So we did get two raw fish, and we gained quite a few levels. We are at level 8 now. So let's not battle level 10. Let's battle this one. and we'll battle this one again. We got Mud Slap now, which should do quite a bit more damage. Actually, no, but it decreases accuracy, so that's good enough. So I'll continue to use Tackle. It is actually doing more damage, and yeah, so hopefully once we get like a Swampert and all that, we should be pretty powerful, a pretty powerful Pokemon. So hopefully after this guy, we'll actually gain at least two more levels. If we're level 10, we could probably almost take on the guy. Oh, we did learn Water Gun, so that's going to be hugely effective, or just hugely helpful, rather. So let's go see if we could find the Machop again. I will try and challenge him. He's going to be quite a few levels higher than me, but maybe we'll be able to pull it off. Oh, please don't tell me he's gone. Oh, no. I don't see him. Oh, Pharaoh initiated a battle with me. I'm going to run away. I could not escape, so let's run away again. He's going to pluck and kill me. See, this is why we're going to use Poke Heal in the beginning, because otherwise it would be very, very difficult to kill him. There's a Machop right there. If you're like a level 16, I'll fight you. Level 35. Ooh, that would be not a horrible idea to catch, because you'll evolve instantly, and we can get a flying Pokemon right off the bat. So I'm getting the vibe that the Machop may have despawned, so I'm just going to hang out at the ocean again, and we'll just continue to kill down these Magikarp Eye. We got a crit right there, so that is awesome. Probably should have battled a higher level one. If I see an 18, level 18 Magikarp, though, I will just catch it. I will just straight out catch it, and just level it up two levels, get a Gyarados, and be happy with my life, because that's what you do as the Pokemon Master. You get Gyarados. Alright, so level 13 Magikarp. I guess I'll battle you. You're getting to be pushing it to the the levels are getting really close to me. Once we learn, if we could find like a nice little desert, we could easily level up Mudkip here. And I think it'll be all around. But let me know in the comments down below, as it is kind of not slow, but the first episode is always going to be probably the slowest episode as we try and train up our team. But let me know in the comments down below, are you excited for the second map? I know a lot of you guys did enjoy the first Pixelmon Soul of Fire, and this is the sequel. So, I mean, obviously, hopefully it is quite enjoyable for you guys again. And yeah, it does not look like that Machop did decide to stay around. It does look like he did flee the scene, but that's going to be okay, because I'm sure there'll be many, many more boss Pokemon. It was kind of cool, though, to see a blue boss like that. It did... Ooh, there's a Monferno right there. Huh. Should I go... If he's low level, I could totally kill him. 26, that's... Yeah, we're only level 11, so that's going to be a bit ambitious for us. But if we go travel this way... Let's see, there's another Monferno. What level are you? You're level 20. Ah, he went for it. Well, we can Water Gun him. It'll do a little chunk. If he doesn't attack, if he just keeps using Taunt, we could totally do this. Oh my god. If we kill this Monferno, we'll gain... Oh god, this is bad. This is bad. Okay, use Taunt again. Torment, Taunt. Okay. Oh my god, please don't kill me. Please don't kill me. Oh god. Please don't do it. Please... No, god damn... Oh, we got him so... Oh wait, no, we did it. We got a crit and we killed him. Holy crap. We just got so many levels, and we evolved, and we learned Foresight. Oh my god. Well, there, that kicks us into the series. That's going to help us, because now we'll get over the, like, initial hump. What is that back there? I don't know, but we'll get over that initial hump that's always annoying to try and level up. I'm going to go hit up the next town right there now, and we'll go see what is over there. And who knows, maybe we'll even catch a Pokemon along the way. So here we go, we got a Marsh Stomp there. Let's go see what is over this way, and hopefully we find some goody goods. And I think this may just be the first town. There is a few Geodudes here. Let me do slash Poke Heal, and then we could take them on. That'll actually be a good few levels, because Geodudes do tend to give out some pretty good experience, and we can almost one-shot them, so that's always useful as well. And 625 experience, cannot complain. Igglypuff's hanging out right there. Let's battle this one as well, and hopefully we'll... What? How did... Oh, it has... That's why we don't one-shot it, because it has that ability. I was like, that should have killed him. So we learned Foresight yet again, but I'm not too keen on that. Just gonna turn it down, and Drowsy, I'll pass you up for the time being. Okay, just kidding. Drowsy wants to battle. So me and Drowsy are going to war, and I'm just gonna Water Gun this thing to death. I don't think we'll... Yeah, look at this. I'm in the water. Oh, God. Nighttime. Well, actually, there's light right there, so let's Poke Heal. Run into the light, not literally, figuratively. And it looks like there is a chest, so... Rules. Oh, this must be the second gym. So, welcome to the training field. So, you'll find high level Pokemon for you to train and get levels faster. There's only one rule in here. Do not catch any Pokemon. This Pokemon are only for training. Okay, so here, let me do slash time day really quickly. Oh, time slash set time day. I forgot. So, set time to 1,000, and let's check out the training field. Is that the flying little center here? Oh yeah, look at these. Oh my god, look at the Abras. Holy crap. Alright, yeah, so this looks like a nice little training field, and we are not allowed to catch, or I'm sorry, we're not allowed to catch any of these Pokemon though, so I'm going to avoid it, and as it did say, they are higher level, so I should probably not too worry about that. I don't think I'm going to Eevee train, only because Eevee training tends to be a little bit of a grind, and I don't really want to grind on the first episode, you know, in the series in general, because it's single player. I don't really see much point at the grind in single player, because you don't really need it, I don't think. So there's the wall still for the little training center. There is something to my left, and there is a Charizard right there. So, hello Charizard, should we battle him? Should we go to battle with the Charizard? I think he'll kill us, but, oh, he has Dragon Rage. You are a cheater, Charizard. Yep, that's a good game. That's okay. Oh, I did that again. No, I don't want to do that. I want to do such Poke Heal. All right, there you go. And there is a bridge over that way. And what is over this way? I don't see anything immediately. There's just a few more bridges. I don't want to get lost. Oh, God. The old map I knew by heart, so I would just wander around aimlessly. But this one, pretty much don't know by heart. So this is where we started. Okay. So if we climb, was there another way to go? What happens if we go the other way? I forget. I don't think we did go this other way. So, I don't know where the second town is, but I imagine it's got to be pretty nearby. So, yeah, what's up this way? Maybe this is where the gym and stuff is. So, if we travel into here... Oh, it does look like there is something up here. I don't know what that is. Let's go up here. Because there's no signs or marks. Oh, there is. There's the Ultra Ball thing right here. So, let's... We got a Poke Chest, and we did get a potion, it does look like. So that's actually not that great from an Ultra Ball Poke Loot Chest, but it's okay. Better than nothing, right? And we did get a Sunstone from the other one, so that's pretty good. So it looks like this is a little bit of a scary area. There's a snow biome over that way. Let's continue traveling down the Haunted Pumpkin Road, and we'll see what else we could find. What is that? That looks cool. I think that's a big treehouse. What is the first gym's bug? So this must be the bug gym. Should we try and take on the first gym? I don't know. Maybe. It will embark us on this journey in a proper fashion. The only problem is I chose Marsh Stomp as a starter, so they're gonna kind of curb stomp me, relatively easily. So not too keen on that. We can sell some of our goods here though. We did get a ton of fishy fish with all those Magikarps, so we can get a bunch of those, and we don't have any eggs. We have some gold, though. Does not look like we could sell the gold here. And what do you have? So I could buy, the super potions. Ooh, maybe I should buy a super potion for the gym. Maybe not, though, because I don't know if that'll be really helpful. We have a netball. That would be pretty helpful with catching some water Pokemon. But I think I'm going to just get some more Pokeballs. For these early times, just having tons of Pokeballs to catch your initial... Oh my god, that was really close. But yeah, again, so having some Pokeballs to catch your early team is probably the most useful. But look at this. Look how pretty this is. Like, oh god. These map creators, they do such a good job. Honestly, you guys should check out the map and, give it a diamond and stuff like that. I've been kind of talking to them about the map. Oh, look, there's a Chansey. Hello, Chansey. Can't battle you. And we can use your Pokemon Center, even though I'm already healed, but that's okay. So let's turn around, and nothing in the Ender Chest, I don't think. Nope. So let's see, what is this? We have the Bug Gym is over down this way. We can go check it out, and oh, what's up here? Gym info. Alright, so let's put the rules over here, because that's from the training thing, and I've been using John's letter quite a bit, so let's keep that. So Bug Gym. And little help. So let's take these two and let's see what they have to say. Bug gym, gym type bug slash poison. Gym leader Seth. Seth is the bug Pokemon lover who always stays on the trees to study them. Minimum level 4. Holy crap, I forgot. They pump up the gym levels in this mod. Oh my god. So this is the first gym, level 40. Throw your Pokemon at the gym leader till the Pokemon will go down and fight in the arena. Good luck. Oh my god. So what do you, you do it here, and then what, they fight down there in the arena? That's pretty cool, actually. Huh. So, yeah, we are not ready for this gym nearly yet. So, we'll throw the little help back in there, because I don't want, did my voice just cry? It might have, but, yeah, I think we need to train up a bit first. Obviously, it is the bug gym, so if we can go catch a fire Pokemon, that's an easy sweep for us. So we may want to go try and do that. But again, level 40, that is quite a bit off from us. We're only level 20 right now. So let's go travel back this way, and should we go into the jungle? I mean, it is the worst possible location to train a Marshtomp, so maybe not the best place. We could catch an Elmoga. I kind of want to get a Camerupt, because I never really use Camerupts, and whenever I try and do new series, I try and catch some odd Pokemon, especially in these single player series, because you don't really have to worry about battling other players. So we'll see. And we gotta go back through the cave now. That was really pretty though, that whole little area there. So let's go travel into here and let's see what we can find. So we do have the bus again over this way. And I think if we go travel over here, I think definitely gonna want to catch a Gyarados now, or a high level Magikarp to try and get a Gyarados. So let's see, level 7, level 9, not high level at all. Hopefully one of these other guys will be a bit higher of a level. So level 16, that's not too bad. Let's see what you guys are. Level 19, that's perfect. So let's battle this dude, and we'll just tackle him to death. I don't think he'll be able to kill me because, well, I battled some of you, like, when I was way weaker. So let's Mudslap because it does a little bit less, I think. There you go. Wow, that was perfect. And we will throw a Pokeball at it. And, yeah, now we level him up once, and we will get a Gyarados. Obviously, my team being slightly focused towards, the wrong type of Pokemon. These are all, I have all, water Pokemon right now, but I'll diversify a little bit later. It's just this was a good opportunity to get a Gyarados, a really strong Pokemon early on, and we can go use him to get some better Pokemon. So let's see, how much does it take to evolve a Magikarp? Oh, my shaders messed that up, don't they? Let's go to stats. Move. Oh, can you not see that? Oh, it's right here. Oh no, I still can't see it. I don't know. He got 50 experience, so I don't know how much he actually needs to evolve. I don't know how much he needs left. So let's try and get a little bit away from this lake. The only thing is there's a tons of Machokes right there, and I don't really want to catch a Machoke. So let's go travel on this way. There are tons of... Oh, a Munchlax. I'll battle you. Let's battle to the death, Munchlax. And let's try and... I'll use the little switching thing so I could get some... I want to evolve that Magikarp. And frankly, if Magikarp battles on his own, he will probably get nothing done. So... don't want to do that. Does he have a higher attack or special attack? I think he might have a higher attack. Our Marshtomp. So let's check that out in a second. We'll grow to level 21, and we got a good few experience for Magikarp there. So, oh, he has a high, his thing, special attack. So, his nature kind of screws us over a little. Oh, is that special defense too? I guess that's, his speed. Ooh. He's slow to begin with, though, so I guess it's not too big of a deal. This Pidgey wants to take me on. Let's tackle him to death. Actually, it's going to take two tackles, so tackle him again. And let's go travel back on this way. There is another Magikarp. There's a few of these. Oh my god, I always find those so funny because they don't have the animation yet for the wings, so they just like float around. You just find a bunch of Pidgeots or Pidgeotos floating about. And what level are you, friend? Oh, I don't know. So we're just going to take him on anyway, and we'll lead with Magikarp since we do have tons and tons. Oh, I did not hit enter. Okay. So yeah, let's go Magikarp. And Magikarp might be able to actually do some damage to an Onix. He has tackle actually, so probably not. So let's battle you. And level 36, that's pretty terrifying. We are super effective against him though. So what? What did you just say? Oh my god, holy crap. That did so much damage, and he does have Stealth Rock, so Magikarp did gain enough experience to evolve. So here we do, guys. Magikarp is evolving into a Gyarados. I am pretty pumped about this, because Gyarados, do I have to explain why I'm pumped about getting a Gyarados? I don't think we do. So let's watch him transform like a fatty. Oh my god, that's awesome. So we did get the biggest Magikarp in the world, and we did get a Gyarados. What is his nature? Does he actually learn any better moves? So you have a high special defense. Oh, it's maybe he'll survive a move or two. But yes, so now we can ride the Ocean Blue on Gyarados, or at least hopefully we can, unless it's disabled. It may be. Wait, no, that's my setting. No, it's not disabled. Never mind. Forget what I'm saying. I want to go battle another Onix, though, because this guy gave us a lot of experience, and clearly, we have a ways to go. So here comes out a Pharaoh. He is going to curb stomp me, so I'm going to run away. And we did get away, luckily for us. There's a Snorlax right there. They never fixed the Snorlax model scaling. I don't know. Well, maybe it's not broken, but I always kind of thought the Snorlaxes are just way too small, personally. I don't know. Like, I think it should be bigger. So, we're going to have the Battle of the Little Snake Guys right here. And Gyarados versus Onix. If I could battle the Onix, I can't find the epicenter. Oh, wait. You're really high level. Crap. Well, we could bite you. He'll use Mud Support. I'll switch back into Marshtomp, who is going to do a ton of damage. Oh, he just cursed. Uh-oh. Oh my god, look how much damage we do. Holy crap, why do we do so much damage to that Onix? We don't gain that much experience, but we gain a decent amount. I mean, jeez. This Onix is level 43. I'll just Water Gun you to death, too. This is a level 43 Onix, and we do half his HP and damage with a level 25. So we're going to learn Mud Bomb. It's actually a pretty good move. The whole mud moves that you learn with the Marsh Stomp line. So we may consider going to the training center now. I mean, we're getting a decent level. Ooh, wait, let's battle you. You'll give us tons of experience. So let's switch back to Marsh Stomp and, oh, Graveler. Yeah, see these pure rock Pokemon? They just like crumble to Marsh Stomp here. So let's try and focus on battling these dudes. And let's see, we'll Water Gun you as well. And oh my god, look how much damage we do. Oh, that is so cool. So let's battle him. We'll kill him, gain our 3k experience, or 2800, close enough. And we got a Geodude here. So let's battle you. It is nighttime here. Oh, wow, we one-shot him. So I think I'm going to conclude this first episode here. That is not at all what I wanted to do. And, so I thank you all for watching. I do hope you enjoyed this little first episode, the pilot episode of this new adventure map. Again, if you guys do want to check out the adventure map, there are links in the description down below to where you could go download it and play it for yourselves. I definitely recommend checking it out. Maybe play along with me during the series. You can kind of keep up. I do plan on putting these episodes out daily, so if you want to see more of them, make sure to subscribe and leave a like to show the support for the episodes. And so as always, I thank you all for watching. I do hope you enjoyed, and I hope to see you all next time. Later.